clean water, healthy ecosystems, abundant wildlife. These are qualities we all look for in our environment and our recreation areas. And wetlands can play a major role in creating a healthy environment by reducing chemical compounds and bacteria in stormwater that runs off city streets and neighborhoods. When contaminated stormwater flows into creeks, bayous, rivers, and lakes, it can harm water quality, kill fish, and cause an overgrowth of algae. Wetland plants help prevent this by cleaning the water before it enters larger systems. When detention ponds are built to provide drainage for new construction, they are not considered suitable for any purpose other than holding stormwater runoff for flood control. But environmentally conscious Texans are helping to change that perception. Through a grant from the Texas Commission on Environmental Quality, the Texas Coastal Watershed Program, a partnership between the Texas A&M AgriLife Extension Service and Texas Sea Grant, has helped to create a floating wetland in the detention pond at the Education Village in League City. The first floating wetland at a Texas school, it is expected to demonstrate a new way to improve water quality in Dickinson Bayou, which has low levels of oxygen and high levels of bacteria. Ultimately, wetlands will help improve water quality in wildlife habitats in Galveston Bay, which is vital for commercial and recreational fishing, boating, and bird watching.
The importance of the floating wetlands for being at a school is that the children, the students, get to be involved in the project, and it's a direct way that they can learn about their natural habitat.
The Education Village is home to an elementary, an intermediate, and a high school in the Clear Creek Independent School District. The campus is on the North American flyway for hundreds of migratory bird species, and as many as half of all these species nest or feed in wetlands. Why create floating wetlands? Because the design of most detention ponds makes this the most flexible and durable type of wetland.
They try to maximize the volume by having fairly deep ponds and fairly vertical slopes. Not very good habitat for wetlands. But if you have a system where you can free the wetlands up from these slopes by putting them in the center in a buoyant raft that can rise and fall, then you get those wetland functions. And it looks pretty cool.
Floating wetland project leader Mary Carol Edwards recruited Texas Master Naturalist volunteers and watershed program staff to make up the wetland restoration team. They collected wild plants from local public lands where wetland plants thrive, and also from a nearby elementary school that had wetland plants to spare in their habitat garden.
Evergreen, very good.
Then students at the Education Village helped process and pot the plants to get them established for replanting. Once established, the plants were placed into three floating islands made of a dense mesh of plastic fibers that have been recycled from soda bottles and other plastic waste. This mesh provides a structure for populations of beneficial water-cleaning microorganisms to grow, the way plant, soil, and root interactions function in a natural wetland. On the day of the floating wetland launch, they were towed into the center of the detention basin and anchored into place, where they will rise and fall with changing water levels and be part of a setting where students can learn about their environment.
In our state standards and in the national standards, our students have to be very astute and very aware of environmental issues. Of course, understanding water and watershed, erosion, and all the different pieces of earth science, as well as physical science and chemistry too. There's all of that involved, all wrapped up into this floating wetlands project.
Well, I'm making a science fair project about wetlands, and I want to know like how the plants clean the water and how the water quality will be improved when wetland island has been installed.
Right now in my class, we are doing an ecosystem project, and so this is like everything that I need to know about doing an ecosystem.
The Texas Coastal Watershed Program and Master Naturalists predict that the success of the floating wetland at the Education Village will inspire wetland development in other areas of the community.
And then when you get one like this, you can work it off.
So the real success is going to be is it works. Subdivision can use it, parking lots, shopping centers, whatever.
I really believe in no child left inside, that the kids need to be outside and interact with the environment. And it's real world connections to everything that they're learning in the classroom. It opens the classroom doors so that there are no doors anymore.
The coolest thing that I think will happen is watching the plants even grow even more and seeing what heights they can grow and see what kind of animals will come in.